This is the Kane Show on demand.
So somebody won the $430 million jackpot in New Jersey, by the way.
Yeah.
Here, real quick, I have a rose. It's seconds away. I just wanted to talk to Sean really quick because Kayla, one of our interns, had her Zipcar turn off on her mid-drive yesterday because her time ran out on it. Almost like you know when you're in bumper cars and they turn the machine, you know, it's somebody else's turn and everyone just kind of slows down. Sean, this happened when you were on a date.
Okay, so a girl who I've been trying to get to go out with me for the longest time finally gave me a chance. The day of I'm leaving, getting off work, my car breaks down on me. So I heard from a buddy about this service, and I was like, you know, it's kind of sketchy, but I'll give it a try.
Yeah.
So I downloaded it, got a car, brought outside of my house, got the car, went on a date. Left the movie theater. As we're leaving the movie theater, she tells me how much of a good time she's having. We get on the freeway.
Apparently, though, I'm getting texts coming in saying Zipcar warns you multiple times that your time is expiring. And because their business model is based on the time of the car getting back so somebody else can get it,
yeah,
it's kind of important.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I could see why that could. I get both sides of it.
Yeah.
But did she end up like leaving you because of it?
Nope. We actually are going on our day Friday.
So all's well that ends well.
Worked out in your favor.
Thank you, brother. Good luck with that, by the way.
Appreciate it, guys. Have a great day. My man.
My daughter wants your Zipcar, or the price doubles if you keep it longer than you originally reserved it for. Yeah, I understand that, too. I would get that. I mean, if their model is the car needs to be somewhere for somewhere else,
and
it was me, I'd be pissed if my car wasn't there.
Mm-hmm.
So I get both sides. I want to say hi to Ashley and the entire Virginia Tech volleyball team on a bus to go meet the president this morning. You go.
Oh, that's cool.
Sweet.
And we're proud of you guys. What happens if you notice a pattern of a guy who comes over and you only meet at bars and comes over to your house and then ends up leaving halfway through an evening? But you don't really hook up with him. You just kind of hang out with him.
Okay.
Is there anything suspicious about that? Take a listen to this rose.
Roses are red, violets are blue. When Cain calls your man, he'd better choose you.
Sarah, I want to back up a couple weeks here and kind of... I think this kind of tells the tale of how we got to where we are now with the roses. So you are out at a bar with friends?
So it was a really busy bar. It was a Thursday night. It was really fun. I was with a bunch of friends. And we're all just, you know, having drinks and hanging out. And this guy, like, comes up to me and you know, starts chatting and kind of flirting and shooting the we were just, you know, we just had a drink together.
Okay. So is that the night that you went bar hopping? Or was it the date after?
We started at that bar and, you know, we were having a good time. So we went out to a couple other bars and had a few drinks.
Okay. So the night is near the end. And do you separate?
No, he comes back to my place.
Okay.
Which was great, but you know, we have this fun time, and he actually leaves like some point in the night, probably like 4 a.m. or something. I got up and he was gone. But I get these texts from him. You know, like he seems like he was into it, and they're sweet texts. And you know, I thought it was a little weird that he left, but you know, he was like being very responsive still.
Okay. And then you get the text, and if I may quote your email and the screenshot, your intrusion into our relationship is not welcome.
That is the text that I got.
I mean, clearly it's somewhere else to be.
Did you call him up immediately and confront him and say, why did I get this and who is it from? Or did you call the number back and talk to the person who...
You know, I didn't call him right away because I kind of wanted to give him the benefit of the doubt. I don't know, maybe somebody sent that to the wrong person.
No.
So I actually tried to call it myself.
Okay.
But I couldn't, there was no voicemail attached to it or anything, so it wasn't sitting very well with me.
Okay, so did you ask him?
So eventually I ask him, and, you know, I'm like, look, I told him the text I got, and he says, no, that, like, has nothing to do with me. I have no idea what that is.
Huh. So then that takes us to date number three. Once again, bar, drinks, and what happens?
So he comes back to my place again.
Okay, pause right there. Have you noticed the pattern here?
Yeah, I was gonna say, you don't think that's weird?
Yeah.
Okay. So he goes back to your place and...
Yeah, and this time we do have sex, and he spends the night, but right after we have sex, his phone is, like, blowing up. He starts getting all these calls. So, you know, I thought that was, again, kind of weird. And he like, mutes the phone, but he leaves the light on, so it's, like, still going off like a flashlight the whole time. And, you know, eventually the phone dies. I don't know.
Wait. When you say he mutes the phone, but turns the... So he muted the phone and turned the flashlight on?
Well, he just, like, turned the volume off, you know, so that, you know, the light is still on. So when it's ringing, it's still, like, the light's going off.
Yeah.
Okay. So he's trying to kill the battery. You know
what I mean? Like a strobe light.
Well, no.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought he left his flashlight on.
I'm assuming, you mean, like, he kept getting calls, so his phone kept lighting up?
Or did he turn the flashlight on to kill the battery?
I don't know. I guess he was trying to kill the battery. I hope that's not the case, but I guess that's probably what was happening.
Was the light on all the time?
Yeah, he turned his flashlight on.
Okay. Follow me with this. So he wants his phone to die.
Yeah.
That way...
nobody can get a hold of him.
Nobody can get a hold of him, but she also can't get into his phone.
Oh, smart. Yeah, because it'd be dead.
Because this was the first time he spent the night. This is the first time that you had sex with him.
Well, as he's leaving, he says to me, do me a favor. You know, I'm sorry to do this to you, but I really think I need to take this slow.
He needs to take it slow.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So the last two questions in your emails, did me sleeping with him so soon ruin my chances of actually dating him? Are guys serious when they say they want to take it slow? Not unless there's something else going on.
Yeah.
I'll tell you
He's hiding something.
Hold on one second. So you know how this works. We're going to call Ryan. We'll do the flowers and the massage. And hopefully they get sent to you. And not somebody else. Hang on just one second. I'm calling for Ryan.
This is.
Hey, Sam Weaver calling from. How are you today?
Hi, Sam. I'm good. What can I do for you?
We're a locally owned and operated flower company. And what we do is every month we kind of do a guerrilla marketing campaign to drum up new business. Because we're such a small organization, we don't have a lot of money to spend on internet advertising or TV or billboards or anything like that. So what we do is we take random subscription lists and pick names and offer up a free bouquet of a dozen roses to send to whoever you'd like, in hopes of starting a business relationship with you. And then you'll see. I mean, I'll be honest here. We're doing a bunch of these because Mother's Day was a little slower than we wanted it to be. So we've got, I'd like to offer up 24 beautiful, fresh red roses with greenery in a vase that I can send to anybody who you'd like. And they won't know that they're free. And just the idea is that we build a bond, a relationship, so that if you ever do need flowers for a birthday, anniversary, Mother's Day, you know, you name it, you know that you can count on us.
Ah, man, my wife knows I love her. I don't have time to be dealing with you guys. This is telemarketing. You're wasting my time.
It's not telemarketing because we're not going to take any credit cards or anything else. It's more of a neighborly, it's the old school mentality of neighborly things to do.
Yeah, it's just a waste of my time.
How much is your time worth? I didn't realize that you were a big shot.
Wow, my time's definitely worth a lot more than what on this phone call.
What do you do?
Does that matter to you?
No, it does, because I would hate to waste your time.
Well, I'm a big shot over at a big shot company.
A big shot at a big shot company.
Oh, that one.
I can tell by your personality that certainly didn't win you the title.
Wow. Wow, do you just have a bunch of free time to waste calling and bothering people?
I'm not I mean, normally most guys take advantage of a free flower offer because they care about whomever they're with. I mean, but if your wife
I'm good. Like I told you, my wife knows I love her. Good.
Okay. And you actually found a woman to marry you with that charming personality.
Oh, yeah. I've been married for 8 years.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
What do you think she'd say? What do you think she'd say with regard to the fact that you're seeing other women?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You have no idea what I'm talking about.
No clue.
Does this voice sound familiar here?
That's me.
All right. So who the f*** now?
I'm a big shot at a big shot company.
So I'm getting some sort of telemarketing slash basically you're backing me in a corner call?
Well, okay. That's kind of telling if I'm backing you in a corner. Why would I back you in a corner? I never said anything about backing you in a corner.
Well, I hear you're calling me. I hear a female's voice in the background. I'm not sure what's going on here, but I feel like I'm being backed into a corner.
Why would you be backed into a corner if there was nothing to be backed in a corner about?
Yeah, how many other women do you actually...
I'm sorry. I just don't have time for this. I just don't have time in my day for this.
You had time last week. You had time the week before that, too. You had lots of time to send me texts and so I think your time is okay.
Wow. So many different ways to handle this.
Wait. What do you mean so many ways to handle this?
We could talk about it.
No, hold on.
Talk to your wife.
So that's implying that you were going to volunteer that you were married.
Maybe at some point.
If
I ever got busted, look like a D-bag on the radio, then maybe I might.
I'm so important.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
each other 2 weeks. I don't know where this relationship's going.
What about your marriage?
Why would there be a relationship if you're married to a woman for 8 years?
Yeah.
That, in your words, quote, knows you love her.
Just not that happy at home. What can I say?
If your wife knows you love her, why would that lead to unhappiness? You're kind of contradicting yourself, Big Shot.
Yeah.
With your Big Shot job.
It may be inevitable. I don't know. I'm trying to work through it. I really like her. We've only known each other a couple of weeks. I didn't want to mess that up by saying, hey, I've got a wife at home.
No, that's why you said, what was the quote, Sarah, that he said he wanted to take it slow?
Yeah, he wanted to take it slow. Maybe he could get a divorce in the interim.
It all sounds funny to you, but it's a serious thing. I was being serious. I wanted to take it slow.
Does your wife know?
Yes.
Not yet.
Yeah. Yeah, there it is.
The Kane Show. Hear more at KaneShow.com.
Hit the subscribe button before you go because I would love to have you here. It would be an honor. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I love you and I will see you all in my next one. Mwah. Bye.